Hey, everybody. My name is Jen Villa. I'm a product director here at Grafana Labs, focused on our core observability databases. And today I'm excited to talk through some of the results we're seeing from our third annual observability survey. This is a survey we run. We surveyed over 1,000 both professionals and leaders in the observability space to get a sense for what's on their mind. So I'm going to take you through a little bit of the results, especially as pertain to how people in the space are thinking about costs when it comes to observability tooling. First thing that really stood out to us is we asked this question about new tool selection criteria, right? So what is it that you think about when you're picking observability tooling for your organization? And what we see there is that 74% of respondents cited cost. This is one of our multiple choice, multiple selection questions. So customers could select a variety of responses, but we saw that, you know, of all the responses, cost was the most commonly selected one. You know, we have a couple ideas for why we think this is happening. So number one, we've reached the end of the time of free money, you know, what many call the zero interest rate period, which means that companies are scrutinizing every budget line item more carefully than any before. We're talking to companies who often say, hey, you know, my entire company has a mandate to slash costs by 25%. Therefore, I need to look at how I can do that even in the observability. Second, many organizations have seen their costs spiral with previous vendors, at least when they come talk to us, right? Which creates kind of a heightened sensitivity around pricing. So maybe at, you know, day zero, day of signing the contract, it was like, oh, this seems fine. We could totally do this. But it turns out a lot of the vendors price by volume, which can often be hard to predict and get right up front. And it also means that when your business starts to take off, so does your observability bill. And that's compounded by the fact that for some vendors, pricing can be complex, which means it's actually really hard to predict what's going to happen to your bill when, you know, your estate grows that you're trying to observe. Lastly, we've seen that observability has gotten easier and easier to adopt. It just results in more and more instrumented services. And that's going to mean an increase in costs, right? Suddenly, it's going to be a several digit or double digit percentage of your overall spend on compute infrastructure. We actually asked around in the survey kind of what does that percentage look like? And we did find the median observability spend is about 10% of total infrastructure costs. Now, you can Google around. You'll see that some other vendors cited numbers as high as, say, 20 or 30%. You'll see Reddit forums where everyone's swapping their numbers or not. But, you know, generally, we're kind of seeing and thinking in that 10% number ourselves. And that can really vary based on, you know, how much you value that incremental bit of observability, right? If a second of downtime on your application costs you billions of dollars, well, it probably makes sense to spend a couple more bucks on observability. What's pretty interesting is that there's a little bit of a disconnect if you look at the data between the criteria for selecting new tools, of which cost, again, was the most common response, and then respondents talking about what are kind of their concerns with observability today. And so while cost was one, again, one of the most common answers, it wasn't the most common, certainly at least when you compare it to that new tools answer. It was kind of answered about the same as complexity and overhead, and signal to noise. What's interesting is if you then filter this, though, specifically to look at CTOs, cost now becomes the standout answer. You know, and I think what's like pretty interesting here is like technology executives, like they're not just responsible for technical decisions, right? They often manage a P&L. They're often always being asked to evaluate build versus buy decisions. So I think for them, cost is going to stick out kind of more than ever based on, say, someone who's more like a tech lead or an engineering manager. To me, it actually really helps explain the growing enthusiasm for OpenTelemetry. And we saw that the majority of respondents that we talked to in our survey were either already using OpenTelemetry or actively evaluating it. And you can see why, right? The promise of OpenTelemetry is to reduce vendor lock-in by standardizing how telemetry data is collected and transmitted, right? The goal is instrument once, and that's it. And you could switch among any vendor you want. So what that means is if some particular vendor becomes too expensive, their pricing starts to become extremely unpredictable, then, you know, you as an organization can switch to another provider without having to completely rebuild your observability pipeline. Essentially, it's like OpenTelemetry is giving you an insurance policy against future cost spirals, right? It's preserving your freedom of choice. So again, yeah, makes sense that there's so much demand and enthusiasm behind its development. Going back to this question about, you know, what is it that folks are concerned with observability? You know, I think it's really interesting to think, you know, certainly there is the cost that you pay to your vendor, but I actually think these other two most common answers are actually costs in and of themselves as well. More like hidden costs, I'd say. Right. So if we think about complexity and overhead of maintaining your observability, that's actually a cost to you in terms of your engineering time, right? In terms of your headspace. And this is where sometimes paying a vendor can make sense. It can be a win. You know, what you pay to them, you sometimes get back many times over in terms of the headache and fatigue that your developers save. So, you know, for anyone considering your observability solution, like, you just want to make sure to factor in total cost of ownership, which includes your time, not just the number that shows up on an invoice. Now, if you think about this signal noise problem, again, nearly as many respondents said that one challenge they're running into with observability is way too much noise, and that's drowning out the signal. And this connects directly to costs in multiple ways, right? Number one, signal noise problem, it's often a symptom of having a crazy high observability bill, right? Because the bill is generally correlated to the volume of data, given how most vendors price. But there's also this other cost to consider, which is increased downtime for your applications. If your teams are overwhelmed by noise when they're trying to use the observability tooling to figure out what's going wrong, they're probably going to miss the critical signals, like indicating what's actually happening. And that means longer time to actually figure out what's going wrong, longer time to detect it, means more downtime to you, which means less revenue, right? That is a cost to your business, because that minute of additional downtime, oftentimes it can cost a lot more than what you're necessarily going to save by paying for less observability. At Grafana Labs, we've recognized a lot of this signal to noise challenge. And that's why we have our adaptive telemetry feature set. Actually, it was very much the inspiration for that. Adaptive telemetry is going to analyze your incoming telemetry data and identify what in there are you actually using based on the query patterns that we see, based on what we know about your services. And it's going to say, okay, this is the high value stuff. This is the low value stuff. And then give you a way to selectively aggregate or sample away things that fall in that low value category. And that's great, again, because of now this twofold savings. You're getting savings on the bill you're paying to Grafana Labs, but you're also getting savings in terms of signal to noise fatigue going down for your engineers, right? Your engineers will have the right data at the right time, rather than having to go through this massive haystack to find the right needle, right? It's like we're basically cutting that haystack in half up front. So you have a smaller haystack to start from. You know, if we just take a step back here, I think, like, while it's clear from this survey that cost efficiency matters a lot, it's also clear that organizations consider observability a business critical function at higher and higher levels. We had this here where we see actually that observability is being talked about again at the CTO director level, right? So it more and more kind of like business critical functions. And so what that means is there is some acceptance that observability is a thing worth spending money on. It's really just about keeping that ratio of cost to value in check, right? And we have a couple of real world testimonials that I think really help paint this picture, right? So one developer at an enterprise software company kind of responded to us and said, hey, you know, by centralizing our observability, we reduced our mean time to resolve issues by 40%. And that saved us an average of 15 engineer hours per incident, which means approximately $25,000 a quarter. Platform engineer at another software company said, hey, by having all of our logs analyzed and brought together, having those performance metrics, we identified recurring patterns of high latency in our application. We're able to reduce our downtime by 30%, which translated to $100,000 less that we had to pay our customers because we were breaching SLA. So again, like we are seeing lots of success stories with observability. So the challenge isn't like, do I do it or not? Again, it's really how do I do it in a way that maximizes the value to my company? If you're interested in exploring more about how the trends that we found in our survey apply to you, your specific use case, your specific industry, your specific role within an organization, I encourage you visit Grafana.com and check out the results we have here in good Grafana dashboard form. You can slice and dice by a variety of these filters to kind of see the answers that align most with you and your role in your team. So thank you for watching. Appreciate your time. And, you know, I hope these insights give you something to chew on as you go forward. Thanks.